Hi, you guys. I'm Phil Town from Rule One Investing. And today, I want to talk to you about whether or not you should ever buy stocks at their full price, what we call their sticker price, right? What they're worth. Should you pay that much? So sticker price is what I like to call the value of the business or what it's worth, or some people call it intrinsic value, retail, you know, that's a bunch of different names for it. I call it sticker price because if you ever go over to buy a car, a new car, right, and they got the sticker on the window that tells you what the price of the car is, I mean, inevitably they'll sell it to you for a lot less than that. So it's just there to remind you, don't pay sticker, right? That's why. So it's not that it isn't worth it. It's just that you know you can get a bargain if you just are patient. So let's talk about, first of all, how do you find out what the sticker price is? I mean, unlike the new car sticker on the window, you don't have that when it comes to looking at a company like a Boeing or an Apple. How do you know what this thing is worth? What do you do to do that? Well, interestingly enough, the truth of it is you can't really know what all the companies out there are worth. There are classes you can take as part of MBA programs at NYU or Harvard, written by some great professors that I really admire, on valuation, the guys that wrote the book on valuation. And they're writing that book for people who are required to put a price on every company, right? In a bankruptcy court or in a merger buyout situation, you don't have a choice of walking away and saying, I just can't figure that one out. You know, I'm sorry. I just don't know the name of that. I don't know how to do that one. No, you've been hired. You're going to have to put a price on it. Okay. So that's what those big thick books are for. They're for that kind of a specialist. For most of us, figuring out the sticker price of a business requires that we understand the business itself. Not just the numbers that are flowing through the screen, but what is this thing do? What kind of business is it? What are the moral qualities of this business? What is the way this business makes money? What kind of franchise do they have? What kind of niche do they occupy? Right? That you're going to need to understand that in order to figure out what to pay for this thing. And the reason for that is really simple. If you can't understand the business, then you certainly aren't going to have any kind of an opinion about whether there'll be a bigger business down the road in 10 years. How could you have an opinion about something you don't understand? It's like looking at a car that you don't know anything about and having somebody ask you what you should pay for it. You know, you wouldn't have the slightest idea, right? If you're honest, that's what you would say. You say, I don't know, don't pay much because I don't have an idea if this is like, you know, a $600,000 Porsche race car or if it's a $10,000 car that is, you know, not a race car. So you've got to understand the business. That's the first and most important thing. And in order to really understand businesses, I personally think that you better be passionate about it and knowledgeable about it within and build a circle of competence about the things you're passionate about. Li Lu, one of my favorite investors, said, investing is just all about knowing yourself, coming to understand yourself well. What do you love? What are you passionate about? And magnifying that, magnifying it over the course of an entire lifetime and building what we call a circle of competence around those kinds of things that you really like and really enjoy. So I'm not gonna get too much into the weeds on these calculations, guys. They get into it. At my 3-day workshop, we get all into this. Absolutely spend a couple of days working through all of this. And when you're done with those first 2 days of the workshop, you will know how to do this for virtually any company. I mean, you can crank it out on any company, but to do it accurately, you'll do it on the companies that are within your circle of competence. So assuming you're gonna go be able to get that knowledge from us someday, I'm gonna move along right now and just say that you also make sure that when you understand the sticker, that you're not gonna pay that for it. As we said, there's a reason for that sticker price name. We wanna pay much less. We wanna pay what we call a margin of safety price. Effectively, we wanna pay 50% discount to the public company price. The reason for that is we feel that a fair price to pay for a business is what that business would sell for as a private company, not a public company, right? Remember, when we're buying a business, we want to think of it in terms of owning it for the rest of our lives. We're going to buy it and hold it. It's a wonderful business, a wonderful franchise. It's going to have a high return on invested capital. It's going to make us a lot of money without us doing anything at all, just sitting here. So we don't want to think in terms of public in the sense of, ooh, it's liquid, I can sell it in a week. No, that's not us. We want to think in terms of the long term. Now, the reason that public companies are priced twice as high as private companies generally is because they are liquid. You can get in and you can get out. And that's very, very important to the entire index industry, the entire mutual fund industry, the entire pension fund industry. All these big institutional funds must have liquidity. Why? Because the length of time they're going to own one stock is counted in days, not even years. Okay. It's like 90 days would be a long hold for Fidelity investments in their mutual funds. So we want to understand that the game is being played differently by pros. And as a result, they're more than willing to pay up. By the way, you also get more information from a public company. So you get a lot more of transparency in what's going on. So that's worth something as well. But the main thing is you can trade it. That's the biggest deal. So what some companies, you've heard of private equity, right? Private equity, SPACs, SPAC, those kinds of things are in the news. Those are just ways of taking private companies and turning them into public companies and expecting the price to more or less double. Yeah, so bottom line, should you buy a company at the sticker price? No, you shouldn't. And it's a discipline. It's just a discipline. And the reason that we don't want to even pay the public company price, even though, you know, if it's a public company, that's reasonably what it should sell for, is because from time to time, it doesn't. From time to time, the market moves down aggressively. And all of a sudden, that company that we thought we bought at a reasonable price is now selling for half of that price. And that's such a shock. And it sets back our investment goals so dramatically that we've just made a discipline, starting all the way back 90 years ago with Ben Graham and working through Buffett and, you know, now down to me, now down to you, is to have a discipline of just sitting quietly and patiently and waiting for this business to go on sale. This discipline can make you very, very rich, by the way, you guys. We want to be sure that there is a big margin of safety in there that adjusts for what Charlie calls the vicissitudes of life, Charlie Munger. It's like stuff happens, right? Stock prices drop. We want to be able to exit this company if we find out we've made a mistake or the management team changes or becomes mercenaries or traders even and starts, you know, becoming spendthrifts with our money. Like that would never happen, right? It happens all the time. So we want to be able to exit when the story on this company changes. So right now, by the way, the market is stupidly overpriced in my humble opinion. There are still a few buying opportunities out there, I'm sure. We're looking for them every day, deeply. You got to do your research. You got to dig deep. You got to use your advantage as a small investor and get down into the little companies that aren't followed as much by the big Wall Street firms. There may be some quality companies in there you got to look for. The main thing is you got to do what Charlie says. You know, we want to shoot fish in a barrel. So you got to make sure you're looking for barrels that have fish in them. And so, you know, right now, the United States is tough. There's not that many easy pickings out there. Boy, last March there sure was, which was great. But now there isn't. Now the market's all the way back up again. So you got to consider before you do the job and say, okay, I've done my work here and now I'm going to buy this company, that you fully understand the business, right? The four M's come in here. Got to understand that business. Which means you understand that it's got a durable competitive advantage. You like the management team. You like the values that they share with you. And you like the products this company is going to produce out there. And then you got to make sure you get that margin of safety. Stay inside your circle of competence, you guys. I can't emphasize this too much. I'm going to say it on the way out here. Stay inside what your circle is. Because when you go out, when you have hubris, when you start thinking you know more than you know, that's when you'll get smoked in investing. I guarantee you, you will. So what you got to do is be patient, wait for that opportunity. The market's going to bring it to us. And when it happens, have your list already made. That's when you step up and you buy, buy, buy. All right. Now I'd love to hear from you guys. Have you purchased any stocks at the sticker, all the way at the top? You know, what's been your experience so far if you did that? Leave a comment below with your answer and I'll be sure to follow up with you. Hey, if you enjoyed this video and feel it was valuable in teaching you more about buying stocks at their true value, just hit the like button, you guys. And please share the video with your friends. This is awesome. Spread the word. And if you want more investing content, just subscribe to my channel. We got lots there. And don't forget to click the button on the screen for a free gift. Thanks again for watching. See you.